श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो 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 राम जय राम जय राम For a change, today we will read a few words of Swami Rama on mantra. Meditation is possible only when the mind is made one-pointed through sustained concentration. One of the most potent techniques for concentration is concentration on a mantra. A mantra is a combination of syllables or words chosen by the guru based on the temperament of the student. Mantra is a compact prayer which leads the sadhaka deeper, unfolding hidden potentiality and removing the obstacles that prevent the mind from becoming one point. Mantra is a compact prayer which leads the sadhaka deeper, unfolding hidden potentialities and removing the obstacles that prevent the mind from becoming one point. The mantra is like a seed and we are like the soil. The mantra needs time to grow and must be nourished. Simply sowing the seed will not help, you know. Those who are engaged in farming, they know very well now. You have to prepare the ground, sow the seed. We cannot stop nourishing, that is, watering, weeding out, manure applying, mulching, so many things. So mantra is a seed. Mantra is like a seed. Ramnam is like a seed. And we are like the soil. The mantra needs time to grow and must be nourished. Perseverance in repeating the mantra mentally and silently slowly creates new grooves in which the mind can flow. Eventually, instead of watching our thoughts, we will begin to watch ourselves repeating our mantra. How the sakshi, you know, develops. Beautifully doesn't happen. Mantra is a seed and our mind is the soil. When we take the mantra, if we just take the mantra, it will not produce. But along with it, so many things are to be done. And when we do that, perseverance in repeating the mantra, mentally and silently, they have not added vocally here. Mentally and silently, slowly creates new grooves in which the mind can flow. Eventually, instead of watching our thoughts, we will begin to watch ourselves repeating our mantra. Mantra is that which liberates the mind from grief and sorrow. Manana prayate iti mantraha. Not every word is a mantra. Mantras are revelations that the ancient sages received in their deep meditative state and encapsulated their experience in the vibratory sounds of the mantra. That revealed mantra, when used sincerely and diligently, creates the same meditative state in which the mantra was revealed. Mantras are effective only when their sanctity and purity have been maintained by an unbroken lineage of sages who have passed on the mantras from guru to disciple. The act of continually repeating the mantra, japa, is an integral part of the most religious and meditative traditions. From mere repetition of the sounds of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, then to the feeling and kinship of the mantra, and further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. Beautiful. These are the different stages. Mantras are effective only when their sanctity and purity have been maintained by an unbroken lineage of sages who have passed on the mantras from guru to disciple. Okay. The act of continually repeating the mantra, japa, is an integral part of most religious and meditative tradition. The act of continually repeating the mantra, which is called japa, is an integral part of most religious and meditative traditions. Okay. From mere repetition of the sounds, of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, then to the feeling of kinship with the mantra, attuning, and then further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to silence, where truth of the mantra is revealed. This is what Papa said, utterance of God's name is to make the mind ultimately still, free from all thoughts. It is in the stillness that we know and realize God. Stillness, silence. From mere repetition of the sounds of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, and then to the feeling of kinship with the mantra, further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. So the mantra leads us to the silence. Manana prayate iti mantra. Mantra is that which liberates one from the whirlpool of samsara, from worldly life. I pray to the divinity in you, Swami Ramakrishna. Among all the diseases of the world, there is one most serious disease. We have tried our best to eliminate the disease, but it is still there and is increasing all the time, and all human beings have to face it. And that disease is called loneliness. We are lonely. So when we get lonely, we try to enter into a partnership called marriage. Loneliness does not go away. Then we try to have children. Loneliness does not go away. Then we try to have pets. Even that does not give you freedom from loneliness. Loneliness still remains. There is only one thing that will give you freedom from loneliness, and that is your own constant friend within, called your mantra. But have you established friendship with your mantra? I have. Do you have any other friend in the world who is dearer to you than the friend within you? If it is given a second position, it won't work. When your mantra, the friend within you, becomes your best friend, then it functions. It will help you always, everywhere. When you are disappointed with external relationship with the external world, when you are disappointed with external relationship with external world, with your ideas, thoughts, desires, then your mantra gives you solace from within and it becomes your guide. So when you remember your mantra to such an extent that it becomes your best friend, then your mantra starts talking to you, guiding you. Now you are a friend to somebody who is very weak, your body. Your greatest friend is your body. But the body is very weak and shows its symptoms of decay. You feel sad because your friend is decaying. But the moment you come to know that mantra is your real friend, you will not be troubled by the decay of the body. Mantra means that which leads you, that which gives you freedom from the agonies and pains of your mind, because it is your mind that stands between you and the reality. It is the mind that creates a barrier for you. Once you understand that barrier, then you try to go beyond that barrier, and only mantra can help you. It is the easiest way to cross the barrier of the mind. The mantra is constantly creating impressions in your heart and mind. When does it help? It helps when no one else can help you. I am talking of compact prayer. It could be one syllable, a word, many words, a long string of words. It depends. Make it a point that whatever you do, wherever you go, you will be remembering your mantra. Even in the bathroom. You don't have to postpone your duties for this. Go on remembering it all the time, even in the midst of your duty. So first we try to understand, mantra means, mantra is that which liberates one. And he is my closest friend. He never leaves me. The only thing I have to remember is yourself. He is with me, in me, but whenever I forget, I get disconnected with him, and when I remember, he is with me. I feel his presence. And he guides me, gives me, and the last line, you know, from mere repetition of the sounds of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, then to the feeling of kinship with the mantra, further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. Very, very important. We are all votaries of Ramana. While explaining about the silence, Papa says, you know, some beautiful word. The self does not require silence. It is always silent. The self, the Atman, the one, you know, the power behind it, it does not require silence. It is always silent. So we are chanting the mantra now to realize the presence of the silence within us. Everything is built on the silence. So to reach the silence, I have to plant first the seed called mantra. Then by perseveringly chanting it, with all the needed nourishment, like irrigating, you know, watering, manuring, mulching, removing the weeds, giving them shade. That means all my external activities should be conforming to that. And if I do that, I have been promised that I will know the truth of the mantra, which is called silence. Once again we will read. It's very subjective. He is my closest friend. He never leaves me. When once I have become aware of him, he never leaves me. People used to say, you know, he is very calm, he is unperturbed, he is always blissful, he is always peaceful. What does it mean? Yes, such is the bottom. The truth of the mantra is silence. From mere repetition of the sounds of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, then to the feeling of kinship with the mantra, further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. The silence of the mantra, no, silence, silence. Silence can be called as, you know, absence of otherness. Because only the otherness creates all these problems. So when we take to chanting of Ramnam, suppose we are trying to make it more and more clearer to us, it will help us. But have we established a friendship with him? Do you have any other friend in the world who is dearer to you than the friend within you? If it is given a second position, it won't work. First is my body. When your mantra, the friend within you, becomes your best friend, then it functions, it will help you always, everywhere. When you are disappointed with external relationship, with the external world, with your ideas, thoughts and desires, then your mantra gives you solace from within and it becomes your guide. So when you remember your mantra to such an extent that it becomes your best friend, then your mantra starts talking to you and guiding you. Yes? Can you hear? Can you all hear?
Chitra, you are able to hear?
Yes,
Yeah. This is very highly subjective. unless one is attentive, it will be difficult to absorb. Here the today Papa chose to speak through Swami Rama to give us more and more amplification, more and more clarity on Ramana, on the mantra. So here a new perspective, a new attitude, that mantra is my closest friend. I should develop a close kinship with my mantra. And he promises, by perseverance, if I do that, slowly, gradually, I try to understand the meaning of the mantra, and feeling the kinship with it, then an inexplicable feeling of presence, vibratory presence, and then slowly I am being led to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. Day for yesterday we heard, you know, Brahma Jnanavali, Sarvadharam and Niradharam, no? I am the support for all, but I don't need any support. No? I am the substratum for all. Just like the space is a substratum for even this very hall, at the moment this is called Satsang Hall. But 25 years back, 30 years back, no. This was an open space. Whenever there is a gathering, we used to put up some sheet. Previously, like that, it was not there at all. It is like this. And then later on, it was terraced and leveled. That's all. Then, idea again, Papa gave to put up the four pillars. And then to have a cover on the top. And it was cemented. While the cementing is going on, one person suggested, why not we have these benches? Okay. Then it was called Satsang Hall. Tomorrow, God forbid, we remove the roof, the pillars, luckily there is no wall here. There is. If that is also removed, what happens? It was a nameless, formless space. For some time to come it acquired a name and form, but again it is becoming nameless, formless space. Even now it exists only in that space, but we are not aware of the space. Because it has got a name and form now. And space has no name and form. So the moment the name and form comes, we become unaware of the substratum. But if the substratum is not there, the name and form cannot exist. So nama leads us to the substratum. And not to remain there, to come back and realize that this projection is on the substratum and the substratum is still there. Even if the form and name is removed, the substratum continues to remain. That is why it is called substratum, Aadhar. So, Sarvadharayamaha, Niradharayamaha. It is up. Space is not supported by anything. Space supports everything. So the mantra takes us gradually to the substratum. Is that clear? That is why it is used as a great void. All of us exist because the reality is called, the reality is compared to space. God, the Brahman, Atman, everything, it is compared, no? Gaganopamoham. It is like Gaganam. Gaganam means, you know, space, Akasha. It is like space. In the space, everything exists. Space does not get altered. Space is only a Mukha Sakshi. One side death happens, another side birth happens, one side noble actions are being performed, another side deplorable actions are being performed, one side construction is going on, another side destruction is going on, another side positive things are happening, another thing negative things are happening, but everything is accommodated by the space. Space does not get affected. So mantra leads us to this truth. So we have to treat him as our friend who is leading us to the truth. Swami Rama, his approach is like this. No? It's Guru. Mantra means that which leads you, that which gives you freedom from the agony and pains of your mind, because it is your mind that stands between you and the reality. Mind means thought. Flow of thought is called the mind. If the thought is not there, no mind.
Whirlpool.
And he put mantra as a wedge and it stopped. Om Sri Ram Jai Ram. You see, when we chant, all thoughts converge into that. You are listening, no other thoughts are entering. Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. The silence is there even now. Just like the space is there even now when we are sitting in this hall. Silence is there in the sound, in the letters. Om Shri Ram. Stop. Jai Ram. What is it that is, the interval, the distance between two letters, you know? Just think how the mantra leads us to the silence, you know? Silence is there. Compare the space, you know? We have put up buildings. Each building has been given name and form. But the building was not there. Even when the building is removed, the space does not get decreased or increased. Just because the hall has been put up, the space has not decreased. When we demolish this hall, that means the roof and the wall, the space does not get increased. So in the space it exists. But when it exists, we don't know that space is there. Similarly, silence is there. Silence is our substratum. Silence is the base in which thoughts gurgle out. The moment the thoughts come, I am unaware of the silence. Think. So the thought has to be arrested. The thought would lead us to a thoughtless state. Here comes the relevance of the mantra. We often used to recollect and quote, you know, in satsang also. When Sinyanjiji was trying, when he was taking the third chapter of Jnana Yoga in Bhagavad Gita. He was trying his level best to make us understand, to arrest this thought. So we are telling to arrest the thought with the help of a thought, you know. We are trying to arrest the thought with the help of the thought. It will never become a factor. So he tried so many, then finally, probably he looking at us. He said, never mind the grammar. When the last thought was thoughted, he stopped. For a second, everybody could understand. You know? Because thoughted is a past tense, you know. There is no word called thoughted in English. But he said, never mind the grammar. Because our mind is used to, you know, when ED is put, it is finished. So he said, when the last thought was thoughted, then he said, you never got it. So similarly, we now understand that silence is the base. Papa's words, you know, but the self does not require silence. It is always silent. One day we took up, you remember, the VPT on silence. Tomorrow again we can take it up. That is very important. Words of Papa and words of Swami Sivanji Maharaj. Elaborate. So the mantra is helping us to reach that stage. So mantra is our help and guide to know our real nature. That which stands as a barrier is the mind. Mind means flow of thoughts. It is the mind that creates a barrier for you. Once you understand that barrier, then you try to go beyond that barrier and only mantra can help you. It is the easiest way to cross the barrier of the mind. The mantra is constantly creating impressions in your heart and mind. When does it help? It helps when no one else can help you. I am talking of compact prayer. It could be one syllable, one word, many words, a long string of words, it depends. Make it a point that whatever you do, wherever you go, you will be remembering your mantra, even in the bathroom. You don't have to postpone your duties for this. Go on remembering it all the time, even in the midst of your duties. Duties are facilitated because of the thoughts motivating it. And thought owes its origin to silence. Mantra stands for silence. So even while we are in duties, to connect us up with the base, mantra. Make it a point that whatever you do, wherever you go, you will be remembering your mantra even in the bathroom. You don't have to postpone your duties for this. Go on remembering it all the time, even in the midst of your duties. You are storing many images, a huge pile of images in your mind. There are many grooves in your mind. The many memories in your life have created many grooves in your mind. And your mind is in the habit of flowing in the grooves that you have created. Now if you want your mind to flow in new grooves that you want to create, you find yourself helpless. But when you remember your mantra, you are creating an image in your mind. Many a time, students think nothing happens when they are remembering their mantra, nothing happens when they pray. Your mantra is a compact prayer. Instead of saying, "Oh Lord, give me this, oh give me that," one uses the word Namaha. Commonly used to complete most mantras. Namaha means not mine. Oh. Nothing belongs to me. We thought it was frustrating, you know. Sainathaya Namaha. Lakshminarayanaya Namaha. Here he gives a new. Namaha means not mine. Nothing belongs to me. Everything belongs to thee. That is the meaning. When you use the word Namaha with that feeling, it becomes part of your life and your behavior changes according to that feeling and according to that thought. So mantra is not only a mere word that creates a form, but is a great thought which has a deep impact on your life. It is a great feeling. It leaves a deep impression in your life. Now you say, "I have been remembering my mantra and nothing is happening to me. I don't see anything." This is a common complaint. This complaint is voiced by those who do not understand the science of mantra. Is it ever possible to do some action and not reap the fruits of your action? No, it is not. When you are performing an action, you are bound to reap the fruits of your action. When you are remembering your mantra and nothing is happening to you, what does that mean? It means that your mantra is being stored in the unconscious mind, and when the time comes, when there is need, the mantra helps you. One of the simplest methods is to remember the Lord's name. Not the Lord, but His name. How could you give a name to someone who is nameless? A child who does not know how to speak, what does she say? Mama, mama. For her, that word is true for her mother. Even aged people say mama. Initially, M.A., 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 mama, mama. For her, the word is true for her mother. You do not know anything about the Almighty Lord. Any word we use for Him is His name. But let us feel His presence by remembering that name within us. A chapel or shrine is where you remember the Lord. When you constantly remember the Lord's name, then you become a shrine. Because the Lord lives in you. Yesterday we were sharing that Malayalam prayer, no? Nanmarupiyaya Devame Nanakku Vandanam. Ee Devalayam Nanakku Nityavum Vasikkuvan. Yatrayum Manojnamam Sadanamayi Bhavichanam. It should become a beautiful residential palace for you, no? And who are you? Nanmarupiyaya Devame Nanakku Vandanam. You are God's goodness. Goodness is godliness. You are goodness. You are goodness personified. And you are now occupying this house. So, kindly help me to make it clean. And so that you live a comfortable life there. Not merely living there. You should be comfortable. All my thoughts, all my words, all my deeds should conform to that idea. The beautiful poem. Nanmarupiyaya Devame Nanakku Vandanam. Ee Devalayam Nanakku Nityavum Vasikkuvan. Yatrayum Manojnamam Sadanamayi Bhavichanam. Vidyayum Vishuddhiyum Svabhava Shuddhiyum Sada. So many words. So what are the requirements? In simple words that prayer comes. So Papa has said, this is a new construct, you know. He is my closest friend, and he stands for that reality, and that reality is silent within me, full of potentiality. Silence is not, it is not absence of sound. That is the only way by which it can be expressed. It is full of potentiality, the great void, not nothingness. So when you constantly remember the Lord's name, then you become a shrine. Because the Lord lives in you. Then you say that if the human being is a shrine, how can the human being die? Human being does not really die. If my garment is worn and torn, I am not dead. The book cover is torn, the book is not dead. If pillow cover is torn, the pillow is not dead. Only a part changes, essential part, Turiya, it never changes. God does not require you to remember His name. God never says you should remember my name. This is a human necessity. This is a support. This is a way. And that way will finally lead you to that royal house which is called the house of God within you. You cannot be lost. You are lost in the external journey where you have to move. This is a journey without movement, where you can never get lost. We will get lost only when we are in an external journey. Beautiful, no? Swami Rama's presentation. He does not ask us to repeat. We need the necessity to repeat to know that He is within me. This is a support. This is a way. And that way will finally lead you to the royal house which is called the house of the Lord within you. You cannot be lost. You are lost in the external journey where you have to move. This is a journey without movement where you can never get lost. You don't move, yet you are going ahead. The only journey of its type. Again. You don't move, yet you are going ahead. It was on the 31st December, when we were attending Gita Jnana Yajna. So when the Yajna was over, Swamiji was getting into the car. Everybody assembled and asked Swamiji, "Swamiji, tomorrow is the New Year day, what is the message?" Instantaneously it came, "Get going, never stop." Move. Never get stunted. But these two words, get going. The spiritual aspirant should always remember this. Get going. You don't move, yet you are going ahead. Physically we don't move, but we are going ahead. The only journey of its time. One of the great sages, Guru Nanak, said something, and all the Bibles of the world say the same thing. Nanaka Dukhiya Sat Samsara. The whole world is plunged in sorrow, drowned in the sea of sorrow. Who is happy? Sukhiye Toijo Naam Adhar. Happy is he who is totally dependent, reliant on the name of the Lord. Not on the Lord. He never said Lord, because no one knows what the Lord is. Your mantra is name of the Lord. Sooner or later your mantra will lead you to the Lord. You are happy because you are remembering your mantra. Happy is he who is totally dependent, reliant on the name of the Lord. Not on the Lord. He never said Lord. Because no one knows what the Lord is. Your mantra is the name of the Lord. Sooner or later your mantra will lead you to the Lord. You are happy because you are remembering your mantra. So that is why Nanak Dev said, Sukhiya Soyo Naam Adhar. Happy is he who remembers the Lord's name all the time without any condition. Don't put any conditions on the Lord. I am remembering you my mantra all the time, but I am not getting any dollars. Well, dollars are there in the bank. Why do you not go to the bank? Why do you not earn? What you are doing is that you are using something great for something very gross, very petty. That is the mistake you are committing. Whenever there is something you can't handle, immediately you say, Lord, help me. It is good, but you cannot escape from punishment for your bad deeds. If during that time mantra tells you, sorry, you have done something wrong, I cannot help you, you say, you are not my friend. You lose faith. That is not good. So mantra, remember to satisfy your egotistic whim is not very healthy. Never apply your mantra, your friend for anything bad. Keep your friend in reserve for that day when no one else can help you, where no friend of the world can reach. Why are you giving that friend a simple worldly thing which you can do with your own hand? He said, through yoga practice for many years, he was able to float on the and reach the other shore. So immediately Bhagavan said, you take a boat, you know, why do you spend it? So for that, for this simple thing, why do you use that thing? The simple worldly thing. You should not use this mantra for worldly things. Why are you giving that friend a simple worldly thing which you can do with your own hand, which you can do with your own feet, which you can do using the other resources? Why are you doing this? The best part of yourself is your mantra. Never misuse your mantra. Do not give your worldly duties to your mantra. Many times you test your mantra. My friend the seer, let me remember the mantra to see if he hates or not. This is not good. You are misusing the mantra. Let your mantra become a guide. Let your mantra become an observer. Do not involve your mantra in such petty things. Now the question comes. If your mantra is a sound, is there a meaning to the sound? A sound is known by its vibration. A harsh sound will give you bad vibration, which you cannot bear. Sometimes children scratch a surface to produce a harsh screeching sound and the parents want to run away from there. Some sounds are very soothing. You like to hear such sounds. Some of the words of the music you can never forget. No, letters are innocent. Innocent. G-E-T-O-U-T. But when you repeat it, get out. Vibration is different, isn't it? C-O-M-E-I-F. Come in. That's what he says. They are innocent. By itself, they are innocent. But when you put together and put it in a certain modulation, finished, a harsh sound will give you bad vibration, which you cannot bear. Some sounds are very soothing. You like to hear such sounds. Some of the words of the music you can never forget. They haunt you the whole day. Keep ringing in your mind. The best way to remember your mantra is by closing your lips, sealing your teeth. What should be the position of your tongue? Tongue always has the habit of wanting to translate your thoughts to give them form. So let the tongue be curled up, upwards, touching the roof of the mouth. You will find your japa has improved. Tongue always has the habit of one person. Closing your lips, okay? Sealing your teeth, okay? and tongue. But tongue need not be lifted up. Tongue can also keep quiet. You try, you know, mental chanting. Without the movement of lips, chanting can take place. You will find your japa has improved, it has become easy, try it. But as long as you are making sounds with your mantra, you are simply counting. Instead of rushing to the external world with the help of the senses, let your mind go within. So what should you do? Remember your mantra subtly. Now there is competition here. Whole life is full of competition. A part of mind says, I will remember mantra so subtly that other part of the mind does not listen. The other part of mind says, I am so alert, one pointed, no matter how minutely, how subtly you remember, I will listen. You will have to create that competition in your mind. With the help of one part, your mind becomes very subtle, remembered. If another part is not alert, you will forget. Another part should not be producing a huge heap of dollars, a bank balance, a girlfriend, a boyfriend. Simultaneously, both parts of mind should function together to help each other. There is no time for remembering the Lord's name, for it is the way, simplest way, known to all the great traditions of the world. The highest level of japa is, and japa goes on by itself all the time. This is called ajapa japa. Japa goes on without japa. You get up in the morning and japa is already going on. It means japa has embedded itself in the unconscious mind, which is rather difficult, along with breathing. Continuous, Papa used to say that continuous chanting will help you to reach that stage. These are all revelations of them. We have to practice it, you know, and see what our revelations are. Some clues are there that will help us. Goal is pointed out by everybody clearly. Methods are different, and each one's method is different. So we have to try and see for ourselves how to improve each and every one, depending upon our equipment. So we will repeat again some of the parts. This is very, very good. So ultimately, when we close the session, something should remain with us. Huh? What are they now? Mantra is the closest friend. Mantra will lead us to ultimately to the silent within us. That is our base. Our real being. At the moment we have no idea about it because it is not an object. So we have given a name to it. The mysterious power which is called the mantra. Perseveringly when we do it, it is a seed, yes. It is a seed sown in our mind. Because we all have the vehicle called the mind to travel. Simply sowing the seed, no. Tomorrow morning somebody is taking initiation. That is like sowing the seed. Unless and until we water it and mulch it and manure it, it will not grow. We have to protect it from many things. Similarly, merely taking initiation will not help. All our outer activities should conform to the ideal for which the mantra is taken. Then we have been promised that it will take us. And it first of all, we have to treat it as our closest friend. And no matter whether we are in any place, we don't have to feel that if we are in the duty, we cannot remember. No. Even during the duty, we can remember just like all the words, you know. All the words that we utter comes from the silence, including the mantra. This is a small book, all of you can see. There are letters in it. We only see the letters, but the whiteness is the background, is it not? If the whiteness is not there, letters cannot exist. But normally we don't see the whiteness, background. That is the substratum. So sound is nothing but the motion of the Papa's word, motion of the, sorry, it is the movement of the first motion then. So sound exists on silence. Letters exist on this whiteness. Activities are nothing but these words. But the words, activities are not a hindrance to the whiteness. But for the weakness, but for the whiteness, the letters cannot exist. But for the silence, the sound cannot exist. But for the substratum, activities cannot exist. All these things are pointed out to us through the mantra. So mantra helps us to, the password again, yeah, is the password, linking ourselves to the divinity within us. Silence is called the divinity, our Aadhaar. And then, anything else?
Compact prayer. Compact prayer.
It's a compact prayer, beautiful. It contains everything. No? Look at you. We should not use this for petty things. God has given us in intellect. God has given us the sense of organs of action, organs of perception, organs of action. God has facilitated all these. He has, through our so many external aids, touched and kindled and brought out what is possible to handle the common run of life. All those things we have to make use of for that. We need not make use of this for that. Here, that is why Papa has been, you know, exclusively for, it is for exclusive remembrance. Chanting is for exclusive remembrance. Every Rashad is here to remember. Not for anything else. To get over this mantra. Mantra is to get over the bindings created by the mind. Manana iti prayate mantra. Manana prayate mantra is that which liberates one from whirlpool of samsara, worldly life. So we try to understand the meaning, not the literal meaning. So we stop with the literal meaning and then it doesn't help us much. Initially a combination of words gives you some meaning, no doubt. But in Sanskrit is a language where every combination contains the meaning by itself. It is not simply they put A and B together. Inherent in it. That is the beauty. Anyway, that part we have not learned. But little, wherever we have seen that. So what is more important is that since we are all votaries of Ramana, today's Swami Rama's talk will help us a long way in getting more and more clarity, not only on the methodology, but also on the goal to be scaled. Lastly, this word from mere repetition to the sounds of the mantra, the sadhaka progresses to the meaning of the mantra, then to the feeling of kinship with the mantra, further to the vibratory presence of the mantra, and finally to the silence where the truth of the mantra is revealed. It can't be explained. Through silence it is revealed. Dakshinamurti Shrodhagatam. Through silence it is revealed. It is purely an inward journey. It can never be discussed. Through the silence it is revealed means we go plunging deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper into it. From all the known sectors, then we experience, that's all. That's all. So try to assimilate and retain as much as possible. Assimilation is important. Manana is important. Tomorrow again we will reread this portion because it needs. Subjective, highly subjective. Hari Om. Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram Om. Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram Om. Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram Om. Jai Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram Om. Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om.